fight back.
Fight back! Yeah. Okay, hit it time. Freedom is under attack. What do we do? Stand up, fight back!
Funny. Yeah. It's just so funny.
I don't think most way. People are going to get that one, though.
Well, there's stamp money out of politics in there as well.
See what it says?
System is broken.
Do
you want it like right there or?
Wherever you want, get it.
No matter what you do to it, it's still money. Yay! Thank you.
Yes. You were there. You were the one that told me about this, and I ordered some.
I had to thank this folks. I'll just make sure I'm going the right way.
I like that one. I just think that most people, if they read it, they wouldn't understand what it meant. I understand exactly what they
That sign up, that's the one I like, yes.
Turn your lights on, Jackie. Show them that.
That's excellent.
media, the mainstream media wasn't here. More and more media attention and media outlets have been writing articles about GMOs and Monsanto. Have y'all noticed that?
Yes!
It has become more prevalent because it is gaining more awareness around the world, and the media has to take attention to that. They have to write about it. When you have millions of people marching about a cause around the world, the media at some point has to write about it. The more people become aware, the more people won't want to buy GMOs. The more people...
That's right.
The more people that don't buy GMOs, the more companies will see their bottom line being affected. The more their bottom line is affected, they're going to look at that and start changing the ingredients to non-GMO ingredients. That's what we want.
Yes, that's what we want.
If more and more companies stop using GMO ingredients, there'll be no reason to make GMOs. That's our goal. That's our goal, is to stop making GMOs. Yes, we want them labeled, but in the end, we want them to stop being grown. And we, the consumers, can do that. The power is in our hands. The power is in our voice. The power is in our wallets. We, the consumers, have the power. Yes. Woo! Yes. Vote with your dollars. It's going to be the consumers that change this, not the politicians. And that doesn't mean stop writing your legislator about every bill that you like or don't like. Always write them, call them. Be proactive, be diligent. But in the end, it's really us, the consumers, that are going to make the difference. I'm going to wait just a second till that goes by. We are on fire! So why do we not want GMOs? Why do we not want to eat them in our food? Okay, I'm just going to go over a few reasons real quick. There's so many studies that connect GMOs to our health. I personally am a walking billboard or advertisement for why GMOs are bad for you. In 1997, while I was running health food stores in Los Angeles, I ate very healthy. I developed a very bad kind of skin condition on my face. I'd never had anything like that. I couldn't figure out what it was. So I did a food tracking on my own and tracked it to corn. Now, this was in 97. I didn't know anything about GMOs. This was the first year they went out into the mass market. So I had to stop eating any source of corn. And to this day, I'm such an annoyance when I go out to eat with people, because my organizers know this. I'm so diligent. I have to find out every single ingredient that's in the food, because if there's one tiny, tiny little bit of corn syrup, corn starch, corn flour, dextrose, maltodextrin, a couple days later, I'll have a reaction on my face. They actually even diagnosed me with rosacea. If I don't eat anything from GMO corn, I don't get it. How many people out there do you know that have skin conditions that their doctors say, well, we don't know what it is and there's no cure? They could probably get rid of it if they ate healthy and didn't eat GMOs.
Right?
If we don't have bees, we have no food.
Save the bees! Save the bees!
Save the bees! and the EPA. It's just, they go back and forth. So if they need legislation, they just put someone in, the FDA for Monsanto, get the legislation, then they go back. The FDA might as well be called Monsanto's second office. We need to stop that. Okay? We need to stop that. What else? Oh, we have the right to know what's in our food. How about that? I know there's lots of other reasons why we don't want GMOs in our food. Okay, one more real quick. Super pests and super weeds. Roundup Ready does not even kill the weeds that Monsanto promised it would. Monsanto now is even having to pay farmers to use a competitor's herbicide that's stronger because Roundup is not doing the job. And that ends up on our food, which we know is not good for us. All right, so we want clean food. We want to save the bees. Speaking of the bees, we have Brandon Pollard here today. He's going to say a few words. Brandon and Susan are the co-founders of the Texas Honeybee Guild. They're urban bee wranglers. So Brandon's going to say a few words. Then I'm going to speak. And then we're going to get on the way and march.
ABC, 1, 2, 3. My name is Brandon Pollard, and I want to thank you. Can you hear me better? Well, obviously, as much as we are on fire, I think if everybody was at Texas OU and they knew what we were up against, that they'd be out here with us today. But I want to thank each and every one of you for being here with us, because I have to tell you, my wife and I, we're the Texas Honeybee Guild, and our bees are in trouble. We need to give bees a chance. Last year, in the decades long of our beekeeping, last year we actually lost 60% of our colonies. So not only are bees facing challenges with bacteria and fungi and viruses, but we also have systemic pesticides and genetically modified crops that these bees have not evolved with. Bees don't understand what they're going to pollinate. They're going to get nectar and pollen from these plants, and because they have not evolved with these plants, their immune system is compromised. So I am so grateful to be in the Nexus of Texas and the Chalice of Dallas with you today, because each and every step that you're taking on this march is a step for beedom, it's a step for freedom, it's a step for food freedom. I want to thank all the chefs that are here today, because without the chefs, we would not be able to get this point across, that bees are an integral part of the food supply that we have. Everybody that's at that Texas OU game is gonna go and have a food on their table, and there's one in every three bites of that food is from pollinators and honeybees. And if our honeybees are in trouble, then we're gonna have some of that food disappearing off of our shelves. So we need to make sure that we are asking people, asking our chefs, asking our restaurants, asking our supermarkets to have clean food, to have food that our bees are going to. These bees have to go to pollinate these crops because they're wanting to gather the seeds. Almost 100% of the canola is genetically modified, and bees are actually going to those canola crops to not only make a honey crop, but also to pollinate those plants. And the bees are being force-fed this genetically modified crop. We need to make sure that we're giving bees a chance to choose the plant sources that they're going to, because if we don't have our bees, then we're not gonna have our food. So for us and with my wife Susan, with my queen, I'm just the lone drone here. But in the way of no foods, it's not about just NO foods and NO farms, no foods, no farms, but it's KNOW, no food, no farms. Because if we don't actually know KNOW our food, and we don't KNOW our farms, and we don't KNOW our pollinators, then we are going to be a soulless creation. And this is the exact reason why we're here today, and we are so grateful to be with you and to be celebrating the freedom for the light that which we stand.
Yeah! Get down! Run GMOs out of town! Get up! Get down! Run GMOs out of town!
Right now! Get down! Run GMOs out of town! Get up! Get down! Run GMOs out of town! Get up! Get down! Run GMOs out of town!
Hey, hey! Ho, ho! GMO, it's time to go!
Don't stop the GMO train!
Got to obey the traffic laws.
A family that protests together.